Okay, so let's get started. Yeah, I'm talking about Kotlin null safety today. And if you remember the first lecture, we mentioned about Kotlin to be able to declare some variables that can be null and not null. And that is about null safety, Kotlin null safety. How to declare a variable with nullable property? In Kotlin, the type system distinguish between reference and can hold null value, nullable reference, and those that cannot be null, non-null references. I prepared very simple examples for you. So let's see the following example here right now. So variable A type string assigned to ABC. Then variable B string question mark assigned to ABC. So this separate string right now. Then B assigned to null is okay, right? Why? Because you put question mark, right? But now if you call the method or access a property on A, it's what is A.length, B.length? Return the length of the string, right? So if you trying to access a property for A length, no problem. But we accessing property for B, we have a problem again. Why you have a problem the second time? Any ideas? So B length potentially causing a problem because B can hold null property value. Okay, right now we come into the most important, how to deal with the checking now, right? How to deal with a compile error when using variable with a null property? And that's what we're going to talk right now. Checking for null and conditions can be done in following for method. So again, the problem on the left, solution on the right side for different way. So again, I remind you what is the problem. B is a string carry ABC, but potential is null, right? B null, okay. B dot length not okay. All right. So how to fix B dot length? That's what we're going to do. Method one has a name explicit null check. This is all pattern you did it in Java always like this. We can explicitly check if B is null and handle the two options separately. So this is the Kotlin, not Java line, but you understand it very well. If B not null, to do what? Get B length. Otherwise, return minus one. Makes sense, right? So the method one is traditional, but the method two, three, and four, the Kotlin versions, new, totally new for you. The first one has a name save calls. Question mark inserted between variable and the property. So another way of using a nullable property is save call operator question. This calls the method if the property is not null, or return null if the property is null without throwing an NPE. What is NPE? Null pointer exception. So you see how is useful this right now. So yeah, Android Studio provide you some help when you run the code, and you will have a choice to choose save calls or another way. Method three is Elvis separator. Strangely, Elvis is the easiest to understand. It sounds very, maybe sounds a little bit intimidating, but Elvis separator works like the following. When we have a nullable reference B, we can say if B is not null, use it. Otherwise, use some non-null value alternative in this relation. For example, minus one. Do you remember question mark in Java? This is very similar to question mark in Java. And the last one, method four, is two explanation marks operator. This operator for those students, for those programmers who love null pointer exceptions, they just cannot live with them. And the operator is used for explicitly tell the computer that the property is not null. And if it's a null, please throw a null pointer exception. And enjoy this NPE. You really have this taste of NPE, you can use it. So this will return a non-null value, for example, is a string in our example, or through NPE. So, like, make a summary for this brief presentation. So you can always make a choice between explicit null check or pattern, between safe calls, which is very popular, Elvis separator will give you always a good alternative, or you can go just old-fashioned way using null pointer exception, like you did in Java mostly. And yeah, that's what briefly we have for this topic. Any questions? Yeah, so maybe we need some more time about Kotlin null safety. So you can visit Kotlin.org documents reference to read about this. Actually, just this information taken from that website. And a lot of examples will be in your practice. Even today, you will see this combination when Android Studio will tell you, I'm not going to compile this. Give me your decision. Save call or Elvis, whatever you want. Any questions? Good. Now we will proceed with our project for lab today.